Hi, today I am trying out Maverick Model 3D by making a model of a Viking type sword. Maverick continues and build on Misfit Model 3D, which is a program that I have used earlier. I like Misfit a lot for being simple to use. Development of Misfit stopped quite some time ago, over 10 years ago I think, and even if it still works well, it was nice to learn that someone has picked up the torch and is maintaining the program. So I am now trying out the latest version of Maverick Model 3D. I'm, as I said, making a Viking-style sword, and it is a pretty straightforward, quite simple job. Maverick looks like Misfit, and at least for this work, it behaves in the same way. I can use it just as I would use Misfit. So, what I am doing is that I have made two drawings with guidelines for the shape of the sword, seen from the front and from the side. I have set them as background images in the front and the left viewport windows. I am switching between those two viewports as I work with the model. From time to time, I check the result out in the perspective viewport. You can have more than one viewport open at a time. Sometimes I do that. This time I just worked with one window at a time. The front and the left viewports are set to wireframe mode. The wireframe consists of lines for edges and points for vertices. The lines and points are white when they are not selected and red when they are selected. I have made my background images on blue background and I have used black lines so that the colors will not melt together. The perspective window is in texture mode. I start out with a simple cube, the most simple possible cube. I then use very simple manipulations. I select the vertex or a face and use move or scale to operate that vertex or face. All extra material in the model I add by selecting one or more faces and extrude the selected area. This is a very safe way to build up a model, which gives you a subtle model that will not surprise you with any strange combinations in the mesh or normals turned the wrong way. I do, however, also use a snap and weld vertices when I need to have a triangle rather than a square. This can be a bit more risky if you pick the wrong vertices to snap and weld. Still, what I am using is the simplest possible methods, so I am in no way testing the limits of what can be done. Just keeping it very simple, 'cause that's the way I like it. Here I am putting an edge to the blade, and this is the first time in this build that I am using snap and weld. I will also be using that to put the point on the blade when we add the top part of the blade. Looking at the blade, we can see that it has a fuller running down on each side of the blade. Fullers are sometimes called blood grooves, which sounds a lot more dramatic, and it is also completely misleading. The fuller has nothing to do with leading blood away from the wound. It is more of a technical question concerning the stability of the blade, and perhaps most important, the weight of the blade. It can also have a decorative function. It also has a certain influence over the sound that the sword makes when you swing it, which can have a certain impact in itself. Having done the blade, it is now time to do the hilt. The hilt is the guard, the handle or grip, and the pommel. The guard is the part that protects you from having your opponent's blade sliding down yours and cut your hand. You don't want that. The shape I am using for the guard here is not very historically correct for a Viking type sword. This looks more like what you could find on a Roman gladius, but I like the form, so I use it anyway. Viking sword is in itself a bit of a misnomer. The sword model was Frankish, and this type of sword was used all over Europe. The best swords used by people in Scandinavia, whether they were Vikings or not, would be imported. Or the blade was imported and the hilt was locally manufactured. Most prized seems the Ulbarth blades have been. So I'm getting a bit off topic on making 3D models. Part of this is because I have done earlier videos on Misfit that really covers everything I'm doing here. So if you want to have more details on what buttons and menus in the toolbar to use, you can take a look at those. I will put some links in the description below. So we have the guard and we will have a handle, which is where you hold the sword. There will be some sort of leather covering wrapped around the handle, and that is called the grip. At the end of the handle we have the pommel. The pommel can be highly decorated, but it also has an important practical function. It is a counterweight to the blade that, if it is correctly done, will make the sword easier to handle. Well, that takes care of the model as such. We also need to put some texture on the model. There is really a lot you can do with textures. I will be doing this in a very simple way, which at this stage might not come as a surprise to anyone. The basis for texture is one or more than one image files that are projected onto the surface of the model. Depending on in what format you are saving your model, that might carry with it limitations in what you can do. What I am doing here ought to work with any format. I am using a single image file. It is square, and the length of any side is using the power of 2. In this case it is 512 pixels in length. I am even using the BMP format. On the image we have 3 parts, each holding a different type of texture. Metal for the blade, different metal for the guard and pommel, and leather wrappings for the handle. The faces of the model is divided into different groups depending on what texture that area should have, and the group has the texture assigned to it. The texture then need to be projected onto the faces of the group. You get to decide from what direction you make the projection. You can use a framework representation of the group to decide what part of the image that is projected onto the group or to the faces in the group. Okay, I'm quite happy with this testing. Maverick Model 3D works quite well for me, and I feel confident that it will continue to do so. So that will be all for now. Bye. Thank you.